We've had a lot of people come on the set. They say 50-50. We've had people say 40, no better than 40. You think actually this thing has a real chance of happening?
Well, I think what you need to do is put this in context of everything going on, right? The only deal that may be a beneficiary of the fact that no one has any idea what's going on the regulatory front,
right,
is this deal. And I'll actually explain why. I mean, who would have ever thought we'd be in a time where they'd be challenging AT&T Time Warner? Right. It makes absolutely no sense. On the other hand, Fox Disney, the administration comes out and says, how great is this? You know, $2.8 billion of synergies going to create a lot of jobs, right? So it's a very unusual time. So you take Disney Fox, if there was ever a deal that should be challenged, right, it's the number one box office studio with the number four. It's ESPN and 23 regional sports networks. We hear nothing about it. Instead, they're attacking AT&T Time Warner. So again, to put it in context with T-Mobile, you've obviously heard all the
arguments. And we should say, by the way, you're advising T-Mobile.
Advising T-Mobile.
Did you read Andrew's piece today? Are you going to?
Well, yes.
So here, remember, the in a way, it's good that things evolve in the thinking of regulators. An example, in the 90s, Sprint tried to merge with MCI. The regulators blocked it because they said, how could you let these two, the only two long-distance carriers, combine at low cost? And they made the argument, there is no such thing as long distance. Well, look how silly that looks now, right? So you know the arguments here, which are scale and 5G and all that. But what's been the holdup in the past on these deals has been the FCC. Remember, when Comcast tried to buy Time Warner Cable, it was the FCC. Okay, that's changed completely. You guys had on yesterday a guy, former FCC person, who said, now's the time. So that was the biggest issue. So no one can predict is how this is going to play out.
Right.
But if there was ever an administration where no one can predict anything, this is it.
So does that mean that no matter what happens with the AT&T Time Warner deal, you're still not going to know what happens? Because we've kind of been painting it as people are waiting to see what happens with this court decision, and then it's either going to be game on or game off for all sorts of industries to try and do combinations. Is that not the case if it's that unpredictable?
I think, as you said before, Becky, you know, game on if that deal does not get blocked, right? Because it brings Comcast into the fore and all of that. But I don't think it has any implications for T-Mobile, Sprint. I think that's separate. Now, I'll give you another example of who would have ever thought. Broadcom, Qualcomm. That's the most interesting of these things. Because they basically, the government came out and said, there's no antitrust issue with Broadcom buying Qualcomm. Here's the issue.
It's a security issue, security.
Here's the issue. If you allow them to combine, the combined companies are going to spend less money
on 5G.
On CapEx. And that's going to favor the Chinese semiconductor makers. This is a whole new theory.
That was a different theory, but not one brought by the Department of Justice. The Department of Justice, when they look at the antitrust issue, they don't look at nationalism issues, you know, whether it's good for the country or not. That's not part of the calculus, though.
But your point is the
What do we know what they're looking at now? Right, they're looking at the fact that Time Warner owns CNN. I mean, I don't know what they're looking at now. We're just in a new world where everything is
evolving. I mean, I don't know if you can speak to this. Was part of the calculus about pursuing this deal now? Look at this administration, and who knows? So let's, it's not a trial balloon, but let's just throw the ball in there and see what happens.
It was impossible with the old FCC commissioner. It was impossible under the old administration. Now things are, in some ways, rightly, in some ways, kind of unpredictably. You know, Broadcom's going to have very far implications, very far implications.
In what way?
Well, first of all, you see how the NXP deal is in trouble now.
Right.
And remember NXP, where Elliott said, the activist said, oh, this stock would trade at 120 even without a deal. Well, guess what? It's down to 105. Mm-hmm. MOFCOM in China may block NXP just in retaliation for Broadcom, Qualcomm being blocked. So my whole point is, if there was ever a time when you try something novel, this may well be the time.
Yeah. You try something novel, but also make sure that you get a breakup fee if you're...
And there's no breakup fee in this instance.
Well, there's been a lot of deals without breakup fees, frankly. You know, what created T-Mobile, we advised T-Mobile at the time, was AT&T trying to buy them.
Right.
That made no sense. But T-Mobile had a huge breakup fee. Here, I think the view is, and there's a lot of deals like that, Time Warner, Cable, and Comcast didn't have a breakup fee. I wouldn't read anything into that.
Okay. What's going to happen with Sky?
Well, we're on the Sky side on that. I think it's, at least it looks like, if you believe what Disney said, that they may bid.
Hey there, thanks for checking out CNBC on YouTube. Be sure to subscribe to stay up to date on all of the day's biggest stories. You can also click on any of the videos around me to watch the latest from CNBC. Thanks for watching.